Uday, I wanted to ask you, can you put this in perspective? What does this mean in terms of your future options? Because as you just heard NDTV's Sunil Prabhu, obviously the government will have or reserve the right to challenge this decision.
See, I think, you know, let's also put this in perspective, because Ken Energy has had a very successful innings in India. I mean, this is a company that struck oil. They've done very well in India. They've poured billions of dollars into exploration, but they've also, you know, it's been a very successful investment for them. They've also then went ahead and had the largest IPO when they did it in 2006, early 2007. And they've got, so this is not a company that, you know, is at loggerheads with the government. And I think, you know, in general, their interaction and their with the government has always been reasonably positive. This is, you know, we as in Ken Energy was a victim of the retrospective legislation. I mean, I think, you know, the target of the retrospective legislation was certainly not companies like Ken, because the reason the retrospective legislation even applied to Ken was because of an internal restructuring, an internal reorganization that led to an Indian holdco being inserted, and certain sort of taxes being claimed by the government as a result of the retrospective amendment. Now that the decision has come, and it's the culmination of a long legal process, both India as well as Cairn have participated in lengthy arbitration proceedings. The award has taken 2 years to come since the date of the last hearing. It's a very large award. It's 582 pages. It's a unanimous decision, and the award of $1.2 billion plus interest and costs is reflective of, and this is not a punitive award. I mean, just, you know, because I've seen things in the press which suggest that, you know, the government is required to pay all this out. It's the reason why all of these amounts have been awarded by the tribunal is because it reflects the value of the shares of Cairn Energy Limited, which it had in India, which were then initially frozen and then subsequently appropriated, and also the dividends that were due to Cairn Energy Limited, which were then, again, under Garnishi order, were appropriated by the government. So what you're really getting back is what the government has already taken away from Cairn. So it has a more restitutionary aspect. And I don't know what the government is going to do, because Cairn Energy Limited, it's more about the shareholders of Cairn Energy and less about the company itself. Cairn Energy Limited it's listed on the London Stock Exchange. It's been listed for over 30 years there. And its investors include, you know, all the big institutional names like BlackRock and Schroders and Legal & General and Fidelity, Aviva. It's these guys that are going to be really interested in seeing how the government now reacts towards this particular judgment. For what it's worth, both the UK government and the Indian government, as recently as October 2020, where the finance minister also went on record to say that she wasn't in favor of, in principle, in favor of retrospective legislation. So let's see. I mean, I'm still hopeful that the government will do, you know, what we certainly believe is right. But we're hopeful that the government will honor its obligations. And so far, at least, the interaction with the government has been very positive.
Sure. All right. Uday Walia, many thanks for joining us right here on NDTV.